According to the Mahabharata, Amba, a princess of Kashi, was secretly in love with Prince Sharva, the monarch of Saubala kingdom. Ambika and Ambalika were her younger sisters. The king of Kashi declared Swayambara for her three daughters one lovely day. In that Swayambara, Amba was set to choose Shalva as her spouse. However, Bhishma unexpectedly appeared in Swayambara and stole all three princesses to marry his youngest stepbrother, Vichitravirya. Because the king of Kashi did not send an invitation to Kuru dynasty and he believed Vichitravirya was inferior to him, Amba implored Vichitravirya to let her go to Shalva, her love, in front of him. Vichitravirya also permitted her, despite the fact that he already had two wives, Ambika and Ambalika. Shalva refused to accept Amba since she had been touched by another man. Unfortunately, Amba returned to Vichitravirya and demanded that he accept her. Amba's luck, however, was not on her side. Vichitravirya also turned her down, claiming that he had given her to someone and that he couldn't return his gift. Amba was astounded. She went to Bhishma and pleaded with him to marry her. Bhishma, on the other hand, was unable to assist her since, at his stepmother's request, he had sworn a vow of celibacy. So, he gave Amba the choice of going back to her father or staying here as a maid. After all, Amba was a princess, and Bhishma's suggestion that she become a servant damaged her feelings. "You are the one who abducted me and brought me into this hell, where I have to suffer for the rest of my life," she said at Bhishma. "You are solely responsible for my misery, and you will undoubtedly suffer." As a result, she began to pray to Kartikeya, the god of war. He presented her with an evergreen lotus garden, promising that whoever accepts it will be able to kill Bhishma. This gift made Amba very happy. She contacted all of Kuru dynasty's famous warriors and foes. No one, however, had the fortitude to accept the garden. Draupada, a king of Panchala who had rivalry with Drona, a royal instructor of Kuru dynasty, was requested. But when Draupada failed her, she threw the garland, which fell on one of Draupada's palace pillars, out of rage. Amba was now certain that only Mahadev could assist her. She became a Lord Shiva devotee. Shiva came in front of her and informed her, as Bhishma's vow of celibacy provided him the benefit of selecting the moment of his death, "You can only be the righteous cause of his death, which is not conceivable in this life." When she heard this, she leaped into the flames and killed herself. In her future life, she was born as Draupada's brother, Shikhandi, and assisted the Pandavas in defeating Bhishma.